Hello, it's Peter Geary here. It's Friday and I've got Friday figures for you. So last week we looked at villas and how the prices have changed from the highs in 2006 and today. And we saw that some markets were overpriced and some were less. So I thought, given a lot of clients are asking me about that same analysis for Sea Pines, I looked at Sea Pines rows 1 through 5 to see what would that same analysis look like? What were the prices like in 2006 and what are they today? So let's take a look at this. These are single family residences. And here's the first chart. So if you looked at the unadjusted average sale price in Sea Pines for beachfront, row 1, 2003 to 2021, you'll see that the average price was $6.8 million in 2006. Okay? That compares to today of $4.3 million. In 2021. And now that's through August today, 27th, all right? And so you see that the unadjusted prices were actually still higher in 2006 and 2007 for row 1. This is beachfront, right? So now, what if you looked at rows 1 through 5, right? And that's what I did here. The average price in 2006 was 2.78. So 2.8 million there was the average price in 2006 for rows 1 through 5. That's actually increased, right? So you've increased by almost 300,000, 10% to today. And so when you add in the rows 1 through 5, what you're seeing is that rows 2, 3, 4, 5 are increasing faster than the front row, right? That's what we're seeing. And you can see the prices we're getting second row, third row, they're in 3 or 4 million. So this is a big change. Now, what I thought was interesting was, what was the maximum price? Because what's a lot of times we had a $9.9 million sale, it will drive these averages. So let's look at what the max sale price was over the last, since 2006. If you can believe it, in 2006, $9.2 million was the sale price of the highest priced property. And in 9.9 here in 2021. This is Whistling Swan. This one was Surf Scoter, I think 38 Surf Scoter. So you can see that we've had highs, and in the years around it, 7.5 and 7.5 for 2005 and 7, and here you've got 7.6, 7.8. It's right in there. So it's not like we're way off. Now you have to remember though, these are unadjusted dollars. So 9.2 million in today's dollars is way more. And take a look at what that looks like. So I looked at adjusted prices. So if you took the 2006 and adjusted for inflation, look what happens. Row 1, the average price as you saw was 6.8. If you adjust that into today's dollars, it's 9.2 million, right? The actual we saw was, the average was only 4.3. Now, if you looked at 1 through 5, the average was 2.7. You adjust that in today's dollars, 3.7 million. So it gives you an idea that we're still not overpriced. And then I did row 1, right? This is like the highest sales, max sales in 2005, 6, 7, 18, and 21. So Whistling Swan, 17 Whistling Swan, 2005, sold for 7.5 million. That's 10.5 today. And if you look at Surf Scoter, it was at 2.06. You saw that 9.2 number on the previous chart. That is a value of 12.46 million, right? That's just inflation adjusted. And you look at Black Skimmer, 7.5 to 9.8. And now Whistling Swan sold twice, right, recently. 2018, it was 8.7. That's an adjusted price of 9.4. And actually, it sold for 9.9, so a little bit over. Now, these big, heavy prices of 9.9 million, you're asking, oh my God, they seem overpriced. I actually don't think they really are. I think we're just getting back to our 2006-7 prices. Now, the volume of those sales in 2006-7 is about half of what it is in 2021 to date. So there's definitely more action in 2021, but the average prices are still, not back to where we were. And in row 1, they're significantly below still. So, and as we look at maximum prices, as I said, overall, they're above 2006, but again, adjusting for inflation, they're still lagging. So net-net, time is right to buy and sell on Hilton Head. So just if you have any questions, don't hesitate to text me or call me and like and share the information. Thanks a lot. And you guys have a great weekend.